Merry October.
Hello, everybody.
Merry October.
Merry October. Happy fall.
Wait, what? It's not Christmas yet?
It's not even quite in the 70s
no,
yet.
No. But we're close. We're in a Christmas store.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Frank Murphy for Mountain Fun Life, and I am here with my friends Joseph and Mary, as in, you know, the Christmas story.
That's right, Frank.
And we are at Christmas and Candles, which is part of the Apple Barn in Sevierville. It's really right on the edge of Sevierville and Pigeon Forge, so you can't miss it.
Correct.
Yep.
That is correct.
Just crossed the river.
Been here 25 years.
Wow, so this is a year-round Christmas store with, I see toys for kids, I see candles, of course, that are scented, and Christmas decorations and trees and all sorts of beautiful things. They even, I hear, have elf hats.
Yes. As you can see,
you found one. They also have personalized ornaments and all kinds of the brightest, most beautiful Christmas decorations you can put in your home.
Yeah.
So. All right. Now, Joseph and Mary, this is your second day this year visiting the Christmas and Candles here because you are known locally as an author and illustrator. Mm-hmm. So here's Joe and Mary Moore, and this is the new book, The Christmas Eve Journey, which I have to admit I've read a couple of times.
Oh, well, thank you very much.
And you've read it to me a couple of times.
Yes,
including doing a CD. So,
beautiful. Mary, would you hold that for a sec?
Yes.
Tell us about this particular book, Joe. You're here signing it today, 11 to 2 at Christmas Candles, and this is just one of many autograph appearances you'll have around the Smoky Mountains and all over the country, really.
And especially at this store, what's nice is they carry not only this particular book, which was an award winner, it won the Best Fiction Award for the holidays, but they also carry all our elf books. And so we have the whole Santa's Elf series here, as well as this, and as well as our trilogy of novels.
Now, on the elf series, this is where we learn about each individual elf who has a specific duty at the North Pole. Mary illustrates the elf, Joseph writes the story.
Right.
How does it start? Do you come up with the idea for the elf, or does Mary start drawing something, and you're like, I wonder who this is going to turn out to be? Which is the chicken, which is the egg?
The chicken is, I always write the story first, and she gives her some time to kind of percolate it in her head and decide, you know, what the elf's going to look like and what the scenes are going to be. And she puts an awful lot of effort into that.
Tell us about the elves you've drawn.
Well, we have actually seven books. Six are here, and we have Keeney Eagle Eye, who's our naughty, nice manager. We have Carol Joy Note, who's our new one. She's our music coordinator. Sarah Buttons, she makes all our dolls. Jamie Hard Rock, he mines for Hard Rock candy. Used to be coal, now it's candy.
Yeah, ran out of coal. Yeah. I don't know how that happened.
We need to get you over at the Hard Rock Cafe, which is a stone's throw from here.
There you go. I'm sure they'd have some.
Yeah. And we have Shelly Wrap It Up. She makes all our gift wrap and ribbons up at the North Pole.
Be very careful when you say wrap it up around me, because that usually this is what they tell me that every day.
Oh yeah.
Don't shut up yet. and Ford McCarley.
And finally, Ford McCarley. He does anything with wheels. So cars and trucks and bikes.
Think about that name. Yeah. Ford McCarley.
American made.
It is all American made. That is true.
So are our books. Yeah.
Let me admire your suit, by the way. You've got a little bit of the Santa suit.
The elves said, well, you can't be signing books of Santa Claus in your regular suit, so you better come up with a more business-looking suit. So this is their idea of a business suit. So
undercover.
Absolutely.
It is. It is.
Totally inconspicuous.
It is. We thought so.
Yes, he did. Look,
and Mary's got a beautiful tree.
I mean, you know, this
is it just an Advent wreath? Can I open it? Oh, no.
No messages under there. Except stay out, Joe.
That'd be a great project for you guys, an Advent wreath connected to the characters. I know that's a big deal in our family tradition.
Yes.
Your Advent calendar, excuse me. You know.
Yeah. Yes, and we've actually thought about that kind of thing. We just haven't gotten there yet. We're still writing the books.
We're working on coloring books, too.
Yes.
Coloring books with the elves and that kind of thing.
So, of all the places you've lived in the world, what is it about East Tennessee and the Smoky Mountains that makes you decide to call this home? Because you've traveled, you've lived in West Coast, Midwest, now here.
We travel all up and down the Eastern Seaboard, and I got to tell you, Tennessee, we moved here many years ago, and we have never looked back once. It's absolutely
beautiful. It's the
home
of our heart. I think that the area and the people are just genuine. And they're very Christian, and it's just a wonderful, heartwarming place to live. And so it is. It's the home of our heart now.
As well as beautiful. I mean, you cannot beat this.
No.
Out there, and
the Smokies.
It hasn't even started turning yet.
Yeah. And, and the Smoky Mountains, of course, I mean, are absolutely gorgeous.
Right. At any time.
And you're talking about the Christmas tradition, you got to keep that going.
Oh, yes. And boy, and do they keep it going here.
They really do. And this whole area, I mean, they have a fabulous Winterfest, which is just unbelievable.
Yep.
But all year, you're right, we have Christmas stores that are open all year. So it's something that we're here, and we can always celebrate Christmas.
And Christmas and Candles does a fabulous job with our books, and all our books are signed, so people that can come in after we're gone and pick up an autographed copy.
But while you're here, you personalize them and pose for photos.
Absolutely.
Oh, let's get a
we'll
picture.
We'll do dedications.
All right.
Facebook!
Well, Joe Moore, Mary Moore.
Here we go.
Oh, here, another one. Oh, here, that's excellent. Yes. You know I love you guys.
And
we go back.
You,
we go back multiple years.
We do.
I hope that many, many years into the future with this opportunity to share about what you're doing and what's new in your world.
Well, and we look forward to that.
Yes.
So, anytime you want to talk to us, we'd love to address Mountain Fun Life and let them know what's going on.
Oh, sure. And you can find them online at, North Pole Press? Give me the exact.
TheNorthPolePress.com.
Yes.
So.
Got to get the in there. TheNorthPolePress.com. Find out where Joe and Mary are going to be as they're in and around. They live here. You know, they're always going to be close by, except when you got to go to New York and Chicago and North Carolina.
Roanoke, Virginia next weekend.
Yes, next weekend.
This time we'll be in Roanoke.
Wow, fantastic.
Yes.
So, well, safe travels.
Thank you.
He knows his way around the globe. I'm not worried about him.
Sky Globetrotter helps out a
Keeps
lot. That's another elf that's coming out soon.
There's a line starting to form over at your book signing table, so you better get to it. The Christmas Eve Journey, which is also an audio book. It tells the story of 'Twas the Night Before Christmas, but from Santa's perspective. And, you know, he's the one who's hearing the clatter inside the house and trying to figure out if anyone's awake, and then he goes down the chimney and so on and so on.
He meets Dad.
Yeah. Pawn his kerchief.
Yeah. 200 years later, we finally come out with a new version.
All right. Joe Moore, Mary Moore, signing of the books from the NorthPolePress.com. Here at Christmas and Candles in Sevierville, right on the edge of Pigeon Forge. I'm Frank Murphy for Mountain Fun Life.
Take care, folks. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.